How did you have to adjust the way you played to play with Coop?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. I think he's a different player to Pearcey. He's a different player to Adam Reynolds. He, as you said, he likes to conduct everything. He's probably the best at it in the game. His record is unbelievable. But yeah, we had to adjust a few little things. It wasn't. Pearcey's a very feel player, free flowing, moves across the field. You get a feel off him, whereas Cooper is very direct, square. Mm. He'll take a shot for you in the line.
He's very different in a lot of ways. You saw a more reactive player. He plans, yeah. Even in personality. Yeah. He's sort of very anal. You know, he's very rigid in his ways, and you're sort of easygoing. Are you as good mates?
Yeah, real good mates. I've spent a lot of time with him, and he's been from the day he walked in. He's been real open and honest, and he's kind of just been an open sailor for me to ask and learn off him. And I think probably the last couple of weeks when I've had to play halfback, from probably all the discussions and conversations we've had over the last 12 months, I really learned. Mm. I've learned so much about footy and how to control people and a game of footy.
You said before, the Roosters last year did look like for most of the year a work in progress, but then you play your best football late. Let's talk about grand final week, and Coop does his shoulder. It's likely he's not going to play. How did you feel going into that game, thinking that you got the keys to the car, you to run the show?
Yeah, it was a weird feeling, man. I didn't know how it was going to go, but I didn't really have to convince myself to be confident. As soon as I found out, I was just like, let's go, you know. We'd worked so hard to get ourselves in this position. They'd lost three or four prelims in the years before, and just once you get to that big stage, it's time to go. You got no excuse. No one remembers who did or didn't play. You turn up and you do your job. And I knew clearly what I had to do,
yeah,
which helped.
Interesting. We had Joey on a couple of weeks ago, and I asked Joey, best game you ever played, and he spoke about that Origin series when he came back. Yeah. And I said to him, did you know you were going to play that good? And he went, yep, I did. Did you know you were about to play the game of your life?
I didn't. No, it was going to be the game of life. I knew what I was going to do. Like, I knew, and I felt the energy in the team of, mate, our forward pack set that whole thing up. I think they put me in good positions to kick the ball where I wanted to. Yeah. And obviously with the firepower outside me, helped.
What was the plan on the night? Because Cooper basically took no part. Mm. He was just out there probably for confidence for the squad, yeah, and his presence and ability to talk around the field. What was the plan between you both?
Yeah, so we just sat Coops on short sides. If you watch the game back, I tended to try and play both sides. Coops would sit on a short side to try and hold. We tried to hold four defenders there, and me and Teddy basically played together.
The open field.
Me and Teddy wanted to play on the right, we'd go play on the right. Me and Teddy wanted to play on the left, we'd go play on the left.
Yep.
Cooper was just sat on the short side as a...
To keep him honest.
As a dummy, basically, but he led us around there and with his talk, obviously. But even through those mid to yardage sets, I kind of just got to do whatever I wanted.